And there's a lot of potential in terms of demographic, a lot of young people that want to work that we are training, as I will show you later when I present you our projects here. And there's public stakeholders that are ready to work. Some of the partners here have already been in Djourbel and are now working with us. And I've seen that a lot of local authorities that are here are really cooperative for everything that we want to implement here in Djourbel. So as you see, it's a strategic location in terms of railway. Why I'm showing you that? Because we are actually rehabilitating the railway network in Senegal, and the works have already started in Senegal. And before that, Djourbel was a really, really important center of Senegal. Many years ago, people used to come to Djourbel to take a lot of goods, food, resources, and everything, and bring it to Dakar. Usually, people came to Djourbel for holidays, vacations, and it was an intersection for those who wanted to go to Touba for the pilgrimage. Every year in Touba, there's a big pilgrimage. I'm going to present you that also. And it's connected easily to Kaolar, which is a really, really important city here in Senegal too. There's also a huge demographic in terms of human resources. A lot of people here in Djourbel are really, really young. And it's going to be more and more like that. There's a lot of vocational training center here in Djourbel. We have representative of the technical high school, Cheikh Amadou Bamba, here, which is really renowned here in Senegal. And we have also the Lycée d'Excellence, who trains young people and students from Senegal to be the elite of the nation. Djourbel has also a history of industry. It was really, really important for Senegal. There was the SEIB, Société Électronique Industrielle du Baoul, the Electrical Industrial Society of Baoul, which produced a lot of electricity at first, and then expanded its activities around agroalimentaire, agri-food, and agribusiness. And we have the Sonacos. Sonacos is the national oil and peanut transformation company who has a facility here in Djourbel. Djourbel also is near Touba, the second economical city, and in terms of population too, in Senegal, which has a really, really huge potential. I think that most of you haven't got there, but maybe for a next trip, you should really visit Touba. Every year, there's 8 million people in the city, which has usually 1.5 million inhabitants. For 5 days in September, the city is completely crowded. The highway from Dakar to Touba is really off. As you saw, maybe there wasn't too much people, but when the Magal comes, it's crowded for 5 or more, 10 days. And Djourbel also has an history with Germany. There was a lot of projects going on back in the days with Leopold Sindar Senghor, our first president. It is a historical starting point for the German-Senegalese partnership with the construction of the hospital Heinrich Lübke in 1966 and the West African Hospital Maintenance School. And we had high visibility in West Africa. And it's a really good distribution point, as I showed you. Because we are on the path for going to Touba, for Mali even, for Tamba, which is in the eastern side of the Senegal, and even Gambia. So now I'm going to present you Sidio Group, the company that you are visiting today. It's a company that exists since 2019, but in reality, it started in 2004 with another company called ITSEP, for investment, trading, consulting, engineering, and production. And the main goal was to invest and expand on a lot of domains in Senegal. Because before that, unfortunately, Djourbel suffered a drought for 30 years, which completely dried out the economy of the city. And it was a really, really big project from Sidi to come back to his to his birthplace, I can say that, and do something for the community and help the city develop. So Sidi Group now works in agro-business with the company Afragro. Maybe you've seen the Moringa powder that we call also Never Die, because you never die when you eat some. And there's also consulting for many projects. We are launching companies for construction and sustainable construction also. We are into service too, logistics with SJD, who works in small logistics and import-export. And there's many, many more companies. There's Itzep Glass that produces ice. There's Burnus that produces that sells cosmetics, and Ball Invest that produces rice and peanut oil. So the goal was really, really to try a lot of things, to invest in a lot of domains, to show to the world that we can do a lot of things here in Durban. So for our ongoing project, I will show you two, but the first one is called Daratech. I myself am the technical, the administrative coordinator of the center. And the goal of Daratech is to improve the skills and capacities of local workers here in Durban. As you see, there's a lot of small craftsmen and professionals here in Durban, but they need a lot of training to meet the international norms in terms of work capacity. And why it is really important for us to develop and expand this Daratech is that is to help our future partners and actual partners to find the right human resources for every kind of job. So right now we are focusing on automobile diagnostic and maintenance, refrigeration technique and maintenance, and welding and metallic structures. We already launched the training formation of our future trainers. Out of this formation, we have already 15 teachers. We already have 15 teachers, and we are starting to train students that are already here for the pre-rentrée. Sorry for for this transition. And that will start the formation on Monday. So our partner here are Auto Academy, with Basiru Mbakendiaye here, who is a really, really talented person in Senegal. Who has a long, long, long experience in automobile and maintenance, diagnostic, electronics, and has his own private school called Auto Academy. So he joined us, CEO Group, to implement our structure here in Durban. He's the technical coordinator of Daratech. We have also KTI here for our refrigeration techniques that will soon come. And we have also IECC, there's no representative, there's Fanny. So, oh, sorry, yes, we have two representatives then. For our welding and metallic structures formations. So the goal is for the first phase, because it's only the first phase, is to train 30 trainers, 150 technicians, and 50% of which are women. This is a really, really important statistic for us, because women inclusion into the society is a really, really big issue, important in Senegal, and we really want to do something about it and help people being sustain their lives by themselves. So there's the other project called Pentium D'Or that you will see later. It was a dump site, as we can see in a lot of parts of Africa and the world, unfortunately. It started when Sidi came in Durban. He saw that there was this place, but this place was special, actually, because here in Senegal, we have our national hero, as we can say, called Cheikh Amadou Bampa. So he's a pacifist. He did a pacifist revolution against French colonialism, and he was a really religious guy that has been really persecuted and put in exile for, I think, 8 years out of Senegal. He went to Gambia, and at some point, French administration told him that he could come back here in Senegal, and he came in Djourbel. Touba is it's his main city, but he lived for 15 years in Djourbel. He lived more in Djourbel than in Touba. So this area was the area where he used to walk from his place where he was living to the French administration, where he had to register every day to show that he was here. And when Sidi came to Djourbel one day, he saw, oh man, why do we keep this almost sacred place defied like that? And he decided to do something about it. He bought the land and he rehabilitated everything with his own money, for his own pocket, for the community. So right now, Pentium d'Or is an open space for everyone to come to visit, to chill, to talk, to do everything that life allows us to do. And you can see even students coming out of school and going to Pentium d'Or to work, to talk, to have tea, and to just think about something else. We are expanding with a new project. So right now we are building a training center in environmental and fish farming trainings. So it's really, really important for us to develop the environmental sides of things here in Senegal, because as it is everywhere in the world, it's a letdown domain, and it's really, really important to develop all this sustainable economy. And we are also building this multifunctional classroom to allow other people, other organizations, other training centers to come and to make their own classroom and session. And this classroom is built with our partner, Swedish partner called DAO Office. So unfortunately we have no representative of DAO Office, but we have representative of the Pentium d'Or Association, so right behind. Grand Fay. So Grand Fay is a really, really important human being for Senegal, because he's a planter. A planter is someone that plants trees, and he planted so many trees that we cannot count here in Senegal. He had a really, really strong impact. And he was a really, really he militated for the environment when he was, I think, 20 years old until now, and he's really, really helpful for our project environment in Djourbel. So thank you, Grand Fay. So this is the garden that him and his team managed to build. There we had a maraîchage, so the soil wasn't really good, but we did we leveled a bit, and we managed to plant and to produce all types of vegetables, fruits, and plants. So for our economical cluster, here is a map of our partners. So there's private partners, Senegalese and German, Auto Academy, ICC, ALGA, KTI, August Handel. We have also vocational trainers centers as partners, 3FPT, which is a government organization that supports trainings here in Senegal. We have UAB, University Amadou Alioune Diop of Bombay, which is the university of the region, which is located in Bombay. We have the LTAB, the Lycée Technique Amadou Bamba, which is really, really renowned here in Senegal. We have even professors from this prestigious high school. And Daratech, our new partners, Batology Institute Europe. We have also public investors. We have JZ, as you all know, via its program Invest for Jobs, and also KfW and Develop PPP. So thank you again for the JZ, because it helped us a lot to develop all this network, this economical clusters, and all our projects here in Djourbel. So thank you very much for your attention. I hope that you had a really, really good time in Djourbel and in Senegal, and I hope that I can see you again for later opportunities. Thank you.
Comme toujours, nous a accueillis à bras ouverts. Et pour tous ceux qui sont pour la première fois ici, je voudrais quand même dire que pour nous, c'est un privilège extraordinaire de voir que tout ce qu'on avait conçu quand on était venu la première fois il y a 5 ans, maintenant voit le jour dans la réalité. Hein. Et comme toujours, il faut des personnages qui font le développement sur place et qui prennent le relais en main, hein, parce que ce n'est pas évident, ça a l'air tout à fait naturel que tout le monde est rassemblé ici et que tout le monde soit là, mais il faut valoriser aussi le travail qui d'ailleurs notre mastermind Monsieur Kunz au G7 et vous bien évidemment Monsieur Dorf qui... voilà. Mais il faut aussi louer tous nos PME allemandes qui ont emboîté le pas et qui ont fait présence dans notre appel, parce que je ne leur ai pas dit qu'il fait 40 degrés aujourd'hui, sinon je crois qu'ils ne seraient pas venus avec nous. Donc merci à tout le monde, et je suis sûr qu'on n'est qu'au début. Hein. Maintenant, il faut mettre en pratique tout ce qu'on avait atterré. Mais merci à tous les entrepreneurs, merci à tous ceux qui ont contribué considérablement au succès de ce projet. Et comme on a promis au chef d'État, on va s'inscrire dans la durabilité, hein. L'Allemagne a toujours des intérêts pérennes. Ce n'est pas comme nos voisins d'outre-Rhin qui débarquent et qui s'en vont. Nous, on est là. Et ce n'est pas une menace, hein. Je vous l'ai dit tout de suite. Voilà, donc merci beaucoup. Hein. Ich habe nochmal gesagt, allen herzlichen Dank auch für die, die mitgekommen sind und den Ruf gefolgt sind. Ich habe euch ja nicht gesagt, dass es hier Tag ein, Tag aus bis zu 40 Grad heiß werden kann, sonst wäre der wahrscheinlich nicht so schnell mitgekommen. Aber wir haben hier eine tolle Infrastruktur, auch gemeinsam mit unseren Freunden der GIZ. Vielen Dank, dass Sie sich auf den Weg gemacht haben, und Sie haben natürlich eine tolle Chance, dass hier quasi auch vor Ort jemand ist, der das gesamte Milieu hervorragend kennt, der auch die Stakeholder gut kennt, der das gut ausrollen kann. Und ich denke, nothing succeeds as success. Also insofern, genau, ich bin nicht so der große Anglist, aber so ein paar. Genau, wollte ich Sie nochmal ermutigen, dass wir gemeinsam da voranschreiten und die Chance auch wahrnehmen. Ich denke, so ein paar gute Stakes haben wir ein paar gute Pfeile haben wir eingeschlagen. Und ich freue mich auch auf die weitere Zusammenarbeit.
Ja, danke. Und nochmal wirklich danke für.
Je me retrouve bien dans cette assistance parce que ce n'est pas pour la première fois que je suis là. Nous avons suivi les activités de très près. À chaque fois qu'il y a une rencontre, on s'est représenté. Hier seulement, on était là. Rencontrant un expert en développement local avec les 4 autres communes qui sont riveraines à celle de Djourbel. On se satisfait véritablement de ce partenariat-là parce qu'il nous profite en tant que région en général, mais particulièrement en tant que commune de Djourbel, où on a senti véritablement les retombées à travers Sidio Group qui s'est beaucoup investi dans la commune, à travers un marché qui est construit, avec ce que cela comporte comme coût, que nous connaissons en tout cas, mais aussi à travers Pentium Doch et autres activités qu'il est en train de développer dans la commune de Djourbel. Et pour cela, toutes les populations lui sont reconnaissantes. Et nous vous remercions et nous vous tendons la main. La commune vous est largement ouverte et nous tenons à dire que véritablement tout l'accompagnement idoine sera fait. Ce qui est en train d'être fait avec la coopération allemande, je pense que toutes les régions voudraient y bénéficier. Puisque c'est arrivé dans la région de Djourbel, nous vous remercions et nous disons vivement la coopération sénégalo-allemande qui est véritablement un partenariat gagnant-gagnant et que donc Sidi soit remercié au nom de toutes les populations, au nom du maire. Nous avons véritablement apprécié à sa juste valeur ce que vous êtes en train de faire ici. À vous autres Allemands, je pense que ce n'est pas la première fois, parce que l'hôpital de Djourbel Le premier hôpital de Djourbel, c'est l'hôpital Heinrich Lübke, qui a été construit grâce à la coopération allemande. Ça aussi, je pense que c'est un train qui a pris son départ depuis bien des années et qui est en train de poursuivre son bonhomme de chemin. Donc, soyez remerciés vivement la coopération sénégalo-allemande. Merci.
Connaissance en décembre 2021. Oui. Grâce de ma femme, parce que ma femme a fait son étude ici à Goé et Djourbel depuis 30 ans plus. Voilà. Ça, c'est le résultat du travail de une an seulement. Et nous avons fait déjà la comparaison avec Sidi, avec Djourbel, avec le secteur public, secteur privé. Jusqu'à 2028, parce que notre ministre est totalement étonné, se sent totalement étonné sur le succès de cette collaboration, particulièrement avec vous, avec le moyen de tourisme sénégalais et allemand. C'est aussi notre approche. C'est aussi notre approche pour la communauté ensemble. C'est pas seulement la communauté Djourbel, ça c'est la communauté globale. Parce que notre principe de travail est en base des relations sociales. Voilà, je suis une Toubab, mais j'habite seulement étranger. Ça, c'est autre chose. Mais je pense que c'est aussi important pour les Sénégalais, pour ouvrir un peu votre mentalité. Vous êtes un peu plus française. Donc, je pense que c'est vraiment important pour accepter l'autre culture, parce que tout le monde veut travailler avec vous. Il y a le règlement international. Donc, Sidi, par exemple, ça, c'est déjà le pionnier de ponctualité, etc. Mais je pense que c'est important parce qu'en fin de jour, et ça, c'est notre ambition comme coopération allemande, créer l'emploi. De la dernière semaine, nous avons reçu les nouveaux dates. Il y a 250 000 jeunes qui entraient chaque an dans le marché de l'emploi. Mais malheureusement, il y a seulement 7 000 jeunes qui sont absorbés par le marché de l'emploi. Ça, c'est pas bien, mesdames, messieurs. Voilà. Et ça, c'est notre approche. Donc, il y a vraiment la continuité dans ce programme. Ça, c'est rare dans le spectrum de coopération. Mais ça, c'est notre ambition. Et encore, cette coopération est en base de confiance, de transparence et la communication. Voilà. Choukra.